In this video, we'll be solving this equation from USA Mass Talent Search. So here, we have one equation, but with two variables, and we want to solve for both x and y. Then how to solve it? We're going to start from the left-hand side and see under what conditions the left-hand side equals 28. So now let's see the left-hand side. So here, 4x squared plus 6x plus 4. And here, y squared minus 12y plus 25. So let's work on the first part. First, let's take out the coefficient before x squared. And here, 4x squared. Then here, 6 over 4x, then plus 1. Do the same thing, take out the coefficient before y squared. So here we have y squared minus 3y, here 25 over 4. Next step, we are going to try to make a complete square inside the parentheses. So we're going to do this. So here, x squared. Then this one, for 6, we're going to break up into two parts. So 2 times 3. So put a 2 here. So then 3 here. Here. So 2 times 3. Then x here. To make a complete square, so we need a 3 over 4 squared. So here, we're going to add a 3 over 4 then squared. Then minus the same thing to keep your balance. Then plus 1. So this is for the first part. So now let's see the second part. So here's a multiplication. So then here, multiplication here. Then we also want to do the same thing. Try to make a complete square inside the parentheses. So here, y squared minus 3y. So we're going to do this minus, we need a 2 here. So then we put a 2 on the bottom. So then 3y. Then we put a 3 here, then put a y here. To make a complete square, we need a 3 over 2 squared. So here, plus 3 over 2 squared, then minus 3 over 2 squared. Then here we have 25 over 4. So then plus 25 over 4. Then here. Okay, so next, we're going to make a complete square. For these three terms, we can make a complete square. So here we have just x plus 3 over 4 plus 3 over 4 the whole squared. Then combine these two together. So 1 minus 9 over 4. So that's 7 over 16. But here we have 4. So then here plus 4 times 7 over 16. Okay, so then here, for these three terms. So for these three terms, we can make a complete square. So that's y minus 3 over 2, then whole squared. Then combine these two together. Then outside we have 4. So then here we have 4 times 4. These two combine together, that's 4. So then let's simplify. So let's simplify here. So we have a 4x plus 3 over 4, then whole squared. Then this one, 7 over 4. Let's see this part. So this is 4 times y minus 3 over 2 whole squared. So this one, 16. So now let's see. Because this part is non-negative, it means bigger than or equal to 0. Same thing here. So this one non-negative, bigger than or equal to 0. So that's why here we have, if we drop this part, so then we have only keep this one, so the bigger than equal to this number. 7 over 4. Then for the second bracket, if we drop this one, only keep this number, so that's a 16. So then when we simplify them, so this one is 28. So what that means, we're starting from the left-hand side of the equation. Now we have the left-hand side is bigger than or equal to 28. But then 1 equals 28. So then when this part is a 0, and this part is a 0. Because if this one is a 0, so here we only have 7 over 4. If this one is a 0, so here we have a 16, then equals 28. That's why if equals 28, so equal sign is true. So that means this one equals 0, this one equals 0. So then we have two equations. So then first one is x plus 3 over 4, then equals 0. Then second one is y minus 3 over 4, 3 over 2, then equals 0. So then solve the two equations. Then we have x equals negative 3 over 4. Then y equals then 3 over 2. So this is a solution of this equation.